Okay, so the angular momentum in polar coordinates is given by this expression r into p into sine phi. Okay, now when we defined angular momentum, okay, how it was defined? It is the product of the linear momentum and the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. Okay, the same way from the axis of rotation from the origin, we draw one perpendicular on the line of action of force. This line, again, we call it as the line of action of force because the force is acting along this direction and the same is the direction of the linear momentum. So here we draw one perpendicular. ON is the perpendicular. Okay, now this becomes a right angle triangle, ONP. So in this right angle triangle, we find out sine phi. So in triangle ONP, let us find out sine phi. Sine phi is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Perpendicular is ON and the hypotenuse is R. So ON upon R. That is ON, the perpendicular distance is equal to R sine phi. Okay, R sine phi, substitute it as ON. So what do we get? L is equal to the linear momentum into the perpendicular distance. Okay, so as we defined the same expression here, we got the angular momentum is equal to the linear momentum into the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. Okay, so only these few formulas for the angular momentum. This is the angular momentum in Cartesian coordinates. This is the angular momentum in polar coordinates. And this, as we defined, the angular momentum is equal to the linear momentum into the perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. Okay, these three formulas. Okay, hurry up, note it down. Then we'll discuss the geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Okay, using some geometry, we'll find out one more expression of the angular momentum, which we'll call it as the geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Okay, hurry up, note it down, and then write the expression, write the heading. Okay, write the heading, geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Using some geometry, again, we'll find out some expression of angular momentum. Okay, let the particle is in XY plane. Okay, we draw all three axes, X, Y, and Z axis. Geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Angular momentum we represented by L. Let this is the XY plane. A particle is in XY plane. A particle whose position vector is R is in XY plane. Okay, now a force is applied so that its position vector changes. Its position vector now after a time delta t, it reaches a point Q where its position vector becomes R plus delta R. Okay, here OP is the position. At any instant, the particle is at a point P where its position vector is R. A force is applied, that is, it experiences a torque, that is, the particle rotates and reaches a point Q. Okay, where after a time delta T, so its position vector becomes R plus delta R. Now its position vector is R plus delta R vector, or we may write it as small dr vector. Okay, now its position vector is R plus dr vector. So what is this PQ vector? This PQ vector is equal to dr vector. This is R vector, this is R plus dr. Using triangle law, are you able to see this figure? or I'll make a bigger one. This is r vector. It reaches a point Q after time delta t, where its position vector is r plus dr vector. So what is this PQ vector equals to? It is equal to dr vector. Using triangle law, r plus dr is equal to this vector. That is, if two vectors can be represented by the two sides of a triangle taken in the same order, then the resultant will be given by the third side in the opposite order. So r plus dr, you are getting this. So what is this PQ vector? Dr vector. Okay, so make the figure. Okay, this we have taken to be x-axis, this we have taken to be y-axis. Okay, make this figure. Particle at point P, position vector r vector. After time delta t, it reaches a point Q, where its position vector is r plus dr vector. So PQ vector is equal to r plus dr vector. Okay, still the figure is not complete. Draw this much and then we'll complete the figure and then we'll start writing, we'll start finding out the geometrical meaning. Okay, now what to be done? This is a triangle, we'll make it a parallelogram. How? Draw one line parallel to PQ from O and a line parallel to OP. So it becomes a parallelogram. Okay, draw it. Draw a dotted line. Let this point is S. Okay, so OPQS becomes a parallelogram. Okay, so what we have done? From O, draw a line parallel to PQ. Okay, and draw a line parallel to OP, which is SQ. So it becomes a parallelogram. Okay, now write two lines and then we'll start finding out the expression of geometrical meaning. Write down, let a particle is at point P, is at point P at any instant. At any instant, having a position vector r. Okay, over r you will put an arrow. Having a position vector r vector. After time delta t, it is at point Q, it is at Q having a position vector r plus dr vector, having a position vector r vector plus dr vector. Write down, complete the parallelogram OPQS. Complete the parallelogram OPQS. And here, PQ vector is DR vector. PQ vector is DR vector. Okay, now see in the figure, R and DR vectors are the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. Okay, these are the two adjacent sides of a parallelogram. We'll find out the area of the parallelogram. Okay, so what are we finding out? The area swept out in time delta t. Okay, how much area the particle has swept out in time delta t, which is the area of the triangle OPQ. And this will be half of the area of the parallelogram. Okay, why we are doing it? You will come to know. Okay, so write down area swept out by the particle in time delta t. Area swept out in delta t time. Let it is delta A is what? Area of the triangle OPQ. Okay, so in time delta t, it has reached a point Q. So what is the area swept out in time delta t? it is the area of the triangle OPQ, which is half of the area of the parallelogram. OPQS, as you can see that this OQ line is dividing this parallelogram into equal triangles. So it is half of area of parallelogram. Okay, name the parallelogram OPQS. Okay, so it is half of the area of the parallelogram OPQS. Okay, now when two vectors are representing the adjacent sides of the parallelogram, we know that area of that parallelogram is magnitude of the vector product. Okay, in the properties of vector product, we have studied that the area of a parallelogram is magnitude of the vector product. Okay, like AB sine theta is the magnitude of A cross B vector. Okay, in vector product, in the properties we have studied. If you don't know, you can take out those properties and again see. So this area of the parallelogram, if R and D are vectors or the adjacent sides of the parallelogram, then the area of the parallelogram is magnitude of the vector product of these two adjacent vectors. That is, the two adjacent vectors are R and D are vector. Magnitude of R cross dr. Okay, then the area of the parallelogram will be given by magnitude of the vector product of these two vectors. What is the vector product? R cross dr vector magnitude. Put this modulus. Okay, this is the small area delta A, or you may write it as dA or delta A, anything you can write down. Okay, this can be written as delta A or dA. Okay, this area swept out is in small time delta t, or you may say dt. So let us divide both sides by dt. Okay, the area is swept out in time delta t or in time dt. So let us divide both sides, the left hand side as well as the right hand side, by dt. R cross dr by dt. Now, what is this quantity dr by dt? It is the velocity vector. The rate of change of position vector is what? The velocity vector. So dA upon dt is given by 1 by 2 r cross v vector. Let us multiply and divide the right hand side by m, mass of the particle. Why? Because we'll get mass into velocity, which is the linear momentum. That is why we are doing it. Okay, so let us multiply and divide the right hand side by mass m. Okay, you can write it in the next step. Here I have done in the same step. Multiply it by mass of the particle. So here you have to divide also. Multiplying, dividing the right hand side by mass. So m you have multiplied, n you have divided. Okay, what is this mass into velocity? It is the linear momentum, p vector. So it is equal to 1 upon 2m r cross p vector. What is the r cross p vector? It is the angular momentum. Angular momentum can be written as r cross p vector. So dA upon dt. So dA upon dt is equal to 1 upon 2m magnitude of the angular momentum. Okay, what is this mod representing? Magnitude. So 1 upon 2m. Okay, either you can put it the mod and then write it in the vector, or just you can write down n. What is this r cross p vector? It is the angular momentum vector. Modulus means it is the magnitude of angular momentum. Okay, so from here you get angular momentum is equal to 2m into dA by dt. This expression is called as the geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Using some geometry, we have found out the expression of angular momentum. So this expression is called as the geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Okay, once again, let's see it. Particle is at point P, having a position vector r. A force is applied such that the particle rotates and reaches a point q, where its position vector becomes r plus dr vector. So pq vector is dr vector. We have completed the parallelogram. Okay, now we are finding out the area swept out in time t. How much area it has swept out in time dt. The area is the area of the triangle OPQ, which can be written as half of the area of the parallelogram OPQS. Okay, now these two vectors R and dr are the adjacent sides of the parallelogram. So the area will be magnitude of the vector product, magnitude of the cross product, that is magnitude of R cross dr vector. Okay, now in order to bring it in terms of L, what we do? Divide both sides by the small time interval dt, then right hand side multiply and divide by the mass of the particle. So m into v is the linear momentum and r cross p vector is angular momentum. Magnitude of angular momentum can be written like this only, L. So dA by dt is equal to L into 2m. L is equal to twice the mass of the particle into dA by dt. Okay, this expression is called as the geometrical meaning of angular momentum. Okay, now write down. Hence, the geometrical meaning of angular momentum is given by the expression L is equal to 2m into dA by dt. Okay, that is twice the mass of the particle, two times mass of the particle into this, the rate of change of area. Area swept out in time dt, the small area swept out in time dt is called as areal velocity. Okay, this we call it as areal velocity. dA by dt is called as the areal velocity. So the angular momentum is twice, it is the product of twice the mass of the particle into areal velocity. Okay, write this expression, L is equal to twice mass of the particle into areal velocity. So write down. Hence angular momentum is product of, angular momentum is the product of twice the mass of the particle, twice the mass of the particle and the areal velocity, and the areal velocity. Okay, angular momentum is the product of twice the mass of the particle and the areal velocity. Okay, so we have found out the expression of angular momentum in Cartesian coordinates. Okay, xpy minus ypx. Then we found out the expression of angular momentum in polar coordinates, r into p into sine phi. Okay, then as we defined, it is the linear momentum into perpendicular distance from the axis of rotation. And then we have found out the expression of angular momentum in the geometrical meaning of angular momentum, okay, which is 2m into dA by dt. Okay, then we'll continue tomorrow. I'm ending the meeting.